What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating an NVIDIA application package to deploy to your 9-to-5 job. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is basically download whatever NVIDIA, driver you need to get for, your 9-to-5 job. For this example, I am downloading the Quadro K1200 drivers. And I'm just going to basically select search. It's going to give me this. I'm going to click on download and I'm going to accept and download, and it's going to download it. It's about, I would say, 639 megabytes. Once that's completed, we're going to the download folder. Now, within the downloads folder, it's an exe file. So you are able to right click on the file, and if you have 7-zip installed, you're able to select 7-zip and then pick extract files and just click OK. So it's going to extract all the files that you need. It's going to give you this nice little folder, so double click on it. And all these files inside this folder is what we need to create our package within SCCM. So within SCCM, I went into this particular path, which is my server name, sources. I have a folder called drivers. I broke it down to NVIDIA and then the particular version of the card that I am going to be pushing out the drivers, right? So I copied everything in here. Once you copy over the drivers, we are going to open up our SCCM console and we're going to click on software. Within software, we're going to open up the app management node. And within the app management node, we're going to open up the apps. Now I'm going to select application and I'm going to right click on it. And I'm going to go to folder and create a new folder. Now this folder name, I'm going to give it NVIDIA because, I'm going to be updating and importing more NVIDIA drivers in different styles. So I definitely want to keep everything nice and organized. So we're going to click OK here. Now within the folder, we're going to basically right click on it and then create a application. Now, rather than doing the first option, because this works well with MSI, we're going to select the second option. We're going to specify the app's information. So we're going to click next here. We then need to provide information for this app. So I provided the following, the publisher, the name, and the version. And we're going to click next here. For the software center entry, I just left everything as the default. So I click next here. And this is where the magic happens. So we're definitely going to click on add within the deployment types section. And we are going to basically pick the second option because, again, we're doing everything manually. So we're going to click next here. We're going to provide a name and make sure that you provide the language type for this package. Click next here. For the content location, I'm just basically giving it the UNC path of where I copy those drivers into. And for the installation program, I am going to call out that setup.exe file with the following parameters of no reboot, clean, no EULA, no finish, and passive. From there, we're going to click on next. This right here is important for this particular setup to work correctly. A colleague of mine at my 9-to-5 job actually helped me out on this. He was able to figure it out and it worked with no problem. So from here, we are going to click on add clause and we are going to change the following settings. Now the setting type is going to be a registry. For the hive, we're going to focus on the HKey local machine. And for the key, we're going to give it the following. Now for the value, we're going to do driver version. We're going to make sure we enable the registry key is associated to a 32-bit application or a 64-bit system. And for the data type, we're doing version. Now for the last option, we're going to enable this registry setting must satisfy the following rule. So the operator is going to be greater than or equal to the following value, right? And once you do all that, click OK. And we're going to click next here. For the installation behavior, we're going to pick install for system. Make sure the login requirement is only when a user is logged on. Installation program visibility, I'm going to keep it as normal. For the maximum allowed runtime, I changed this to 60. Once you do all that, we're going to click on next. We don't need any requirements, so we're going to click next here. For the dependencies, there's none, so click next. You're going to get a nice little summary next here. You should get all green check marks, which is always a good thing, and we're going to close it, and it takes you back here. Once it takes you back here, click next. It's going to give you another summary. This is basically finishing up the wizard of creating an application within SCCM. And click next there. Green check marks, always a good thing, and we're going to close it. From there, pick your collection, deploy it, test it out, and hopefully this works out within your environment. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.